This is a Friday Shoes production. This is lesson 7-3 in our books on page 363. And the target is I can find the area of composite figures. Now we've been talking about polygons, but what are composite figures? Composite figures made up of two or more shapes that we have. So when they're odd shapes, what can we do? Well, let's take a look at a couple examples here. And these are shapes, obviously, that we don't have formulas for, but we do have formulas if we break them into pieces. And you can see the first one's a parallelogram and a rectangle if we cut it right there with that red dashed line. Same with the middle one. That's half of a circle or a semicircle, meaning we could find the area of a circle and then cut it in half, and then we have that little piece right there. And of course, there's a square in there. And then we've got this shape, which if we cut down again on that red dotted line, we'll have a triangle and a trapezoid. So we would then find the area of those individual shapes, the two shapes, and then we would add them together, and that would be the total area. So all you have to do is remember a couple, you have to do a visual inspection where you can cut it to make shapes that you know, and then you have to know all the formulas for instance, parallelogram, triangle, trapezoid, and the area of a circle. And a semicircle would be half of that, so we just cut it in half. Let's give it a shot. Take a look at this first one here. It says find the area of the composite figure. Now I see right down that red dotted line, we've got half of a circle, and then we've got a triangle. Right? So let's break it into those pieces, and let's find the area of each of them, and then add them together. So first off, we've got the area of the semicircle. So the area of the semicircle is pi times radius squared, which is the area of a full circle, and then multiplied by a half, which cuts it in half. So we have to find the radius. And if you notice, they give us the diameter. That's 6 meters. That's the full. We need just this piece right here, which would then be 3. And that's where they've gotten that 3. That's the radius. So 3 squared times pi times a half is about 14.1. Now let's take a look at, I'm sorry, that's 14.1 meters squared. But now let's take a look at the triangle. And if you remember the triangle, that's base times height divided by 2, or 1/2 times base times height. So they've taken the base and the height, 6 and 11, multiplied it together, and then divided that in half, or multiplied by a half. And you get 33. So we would say the area of the total figure is going to be the 2 added up, 14.1 and 33 added together, and that's 47.1 square meters. As simple as that. All right. Take a look at these three. Try them on your own quickly on paper, and then come on back and check them out and see how you do against what I do. All right, it says find the area of each figure. So these are all composite figures. They're made up of different figures put together. And we're going to round to the nearest tenth if we need to. Let's find the area of A, the first one. You can see it's, I've cut it up already, and you can kind of see it's got, looks like a rectangle and looks like a square. So let's take a look here. And when I do that, I've got my rectangle and I've got my square. I'm going to pull them apart. So now the rectangle itself, I'm going to pull together those numbers that we need, and then we need to lengthen the width. That's how we find the area, or the base and the height. Same thing. So we have 12 centimeters by 18 centimeters, and if you recall, all you have to do is multiply those together. 12 times 18 is 216, and that's 216 centimeters squared. We always measure in square units. So we're done with that one. Now we need to find the other one, and then we add them together. So we've got this little square over here. I believe it's a square. Let me look. Yeah, if we measure it, we've got 18 here on the long side. If we take away this 12, then this little piece has got to be 6. And that's what that 18 minus 12 looks like, and that's why I have 6 there. So it's simply going to be 6 times 6. That's the area of a square. We just multiply the two sides together, and we've got 36 centimeters squared. Just add them together. So we have 216 plus 36. That equals 252. So we have 252 centimeters squared. That's the total for the composite figure. How about the second one here? you can see this one here, B, it's made up of half of a circle, and then it looks like a rectangle. So I've got half of a circle, and I've got a rectangle. But how do we handle this half of a circle? We call it semicircle. Well, first off, we need to know what the radius is, because the formula requires us to know what the radius is. So we have the diameter. They actually say that's 15. You can see that at the bottom here. This 15 is actually the same length as this right here. So that's 15. So the diameter is 15. We cut it in half, divided by 2, 7.5. That's our radius. Now we're going to take that radius and plug it in. 7.5, plug it in for the radius down here. And of course, we then multiply by, pi times 7.5 to the second power, radius squared. We end up with 176.6 meters to the second power, and that's rounded to the nearest tenth. Let's go on to the rectangle. Very simple. We have length times width, or base times height. So we take and multiply 15 times 7, we get 105. So that's 105 meters squared. Take the two that we have, the semicircle and the rectangle, add it together, and we have a total of 281.6 meters squared. All right. Let's go on to this third one here, and I'll move this up a little bit. So we've got, I'm looking at it. There's a couple different ways we can cut this, but I think if we cut it, we're going to end up with a trapezoid and a square or a rectangle. It depends on how we cut it, I guess. Well, here's how I'm going to cut it. I'm going to cut it straight down there. That creates a trapezoid, and it also then creates square that I can see. Now here's the interesting part. When I flip this sideways, now I've got my nice trapezoid where the bases are on top and bottom, and the distance between them is called the height, and that's the 5 inches. And I got that 5 inches by taking 25 and subtracting off 20, and that gives me this little piece right here, which is 5. So what is the formula for a trapezoid? There it is. 1/2 times the height times the two bases added up. So let's calculate that out. 1/2, I'll take 0.5, times 5 inches, which is the height, and then multiplied by the addition, or the sum of 13 plus 20, which is 33. When we do that, we get a total of 82.5 inches squared. All right, so we have 82.5 inches squared for that little piece, that trapezoid. Now we've got this square here. Very simple, 20 times 20. That's 400 inches squared. So let's take those two, add them up together, and we've got the total for the entire composite figure. That's going to be 482.5 inches squared. Hopefully you see these pieces pulled apart. There's other ways you can cut them, but I'm hopefully showing you the simple ways to do it. All right. Example 2 in the book really reviews what we just talked about. So you can review this if necessary. They're talking about a golf course and how much turf will be needed to be placed down there. You can kind of see there's a trapezoid, and that's this piece. And then there's also a parallelogram, and that's this piece right here. So they actually calculated the areas of both of those and then added them up. It's 22.5 square feet. I'd rather get to this one right here, example number 3. It says, find the area of a shaded region, and there's some pieces missing here. So in the figure at the right, 4 congruent triangles, that means all the little white triangles there are the same, are cut from a rectangle. Find the area of the shaded region, round to the nearest tenth if necessary. So it looks like they took a rectangle and then they cut off the little triangle parts there. So really, if we wanted to, we could find the area of the entire rectangle and then just subtract off those 4 pieces. And that's actually what we're going to do. So we're going to find the area of the rectangle and then subtract off the triangles. All right. So here's the area of the rectangle. The area of the rectangle is, and I did it here in orange, is just 5 times 12. Length times width, we have 60. That is going to be 60 inches squared. That's the area of the rectangle. So now that's the entire rectangle. That's if it was all shaded. Now we got to knock out those other pieces. There's 4 of them. So take a look here. We've got the area of all triangles. Here's how this works. Well, area of one of the triangles, If you look, the length or the base and the height are both 1 inch. So the base times the height, that's 1 times 1. Then you have to remember multiply by 1/2 to get the area of it. So we have 1/2 times base times height. That comes out to be the total area of one of the circles, or excuse me, one of the triangles. So this is one of the triangles. That's the area of one of them. But we want four of them. So notice how it's multiplying by four. So here's one triangle, and then you multiply it by four. When you actually do all that, you end up with two. That'd be 2 inches to the second power, square inches. Now what do? Now in this, and then the previous ones we would be adding. Now in this case, we're taking a rectangle and knocking off those pieces on the edges there, those triangles. So we're actually going to subtract this information. So you'll see here, we take the area of the shaded region, that's 60, and then we subtract off, or excuse me, take the area of the rectangle, and we subtract off the 2. So we take 60 minus 2, and then we have 58 square inches. Don't forget, you can come back and rewatch this video or read some of the examples in the book, or take a look at some of the personal tutor videos on our online textbook. This has been a Friday Shoes production.